Hello guys, welcome to Testing Advices. So I hope now after my previous introduction video, you have made your mind to pursue the course. But if you still not sure, don't worry, let's have course walkthrough then. So when I say learning automation, so it is not just for the sake of interview, but I have designed it in a way that can truly be implemented on respective project in your company. So to implement Selenium on your project, there are certain necessary points to be considered. The first is understanding and having knowledge of the domain and product of your company. Then the second, based on the selection of framework and keeping it dynamic and flexible to an extent that change in requirements can be met. Third, selection of programming language for scripting. It depends on companies, but on most occasions, Java, Python, and C# are highly used. Now in Selenium, we'll be integrating various modules with each other. So we do face compatibility issue, and we should always be ready to focus on R&D and debugging skills. And the most important is practice, which is the key to this Selenium. So these are some of the things which helped me after consistently following it. So I'm sharing the same with you just to have experience of all this. I have divided the course in different phases. So if you guys have seen the course details, then you have already realized that we have started with phase 1. Now in phase 2, I have designed with all the initial installations that we will require, like Java, Maven, TestNG, browsers. Okay. From phase 3 onwards, we will start with basic framework design, where we will learn about feature file, Gherkin language, step definitions, and runner classes. In phase 4, we will turn our attention towards scripting and improvising feature file and runner class. In phase 5, we will learn automating elements from web. So in most of the cases, you will not face issues, but there are certain tricky elements where we need special attention and code to write. While doing this, we will come across exceptions, so we'll try to understand and fix those exceptions. In phase 6, we will learn ways to execute test cases apart from Eclipse. In phase 7, we will step forward with advanced framework designing. While working on it, we are going to get familiar with certain basic Java concepts, also overcoming some complex Selenium concepts. In phase 8, we will continue our work in advanced framework by structuring the framework in depth. In phase 9 is about CI, continuous integration, and for that we will learn Jenkins, its installation, integration, its use, and ease in reporting that we are going to get from it. So this is a complete overview of how we will progress with this course, but this is not all. As on a frequent basis, new concepts, techniques are introduced, and some are being deprecated. So as it has been said, learning is a never-ending process. So I constantly update the course with the new introductions and also the concepts deprecated. So one of the example is like Firefox has stopped the support of Firebug and Firepath in new versions of browsers. Hence I have already replaced those videos. Now to conclude, I will point the things that will be different than other Selenium courses that are being offered. Designing a complete BDD framework. Okay. So here our main focus will be designing the framework. Then considering various features from various websites instead just sticking with one scenario and one website. Then the third is focus on practical working along with theoretical support. This course won't be like everything runs smoothly during the course. Whenever I have stuck or faced issues, I have explained the ways to resolve, and also time and time again, I have discussed the possible issues that can arise. Also, based on queries and feedback I receive from my blogs, forums and videos, I do take valid considerations to create new and update existing videos so that they will have their answers. During the course, if you find any difficulties in terms of understanding the lessons, then you can email your queries on our official email ID info@testingadvices.com. You can also visit the forum for this course, where people share the issues they have faced and solutions that is being provided by us or any other user. Every now and then we do publish some quiz problems with users in order to find the right response and possibly to check their knowledge from the course learnings and to keep up with the competitiveness. Post course completion, you will be awarded with certificates as well. Now, without actually taking any more time, from next video onwards, we will kick off with the course. Thanks for watching the video.